Hi everyone, I'm Shruti and I'm from Singapore, and today I'm going to take you to a trip down south to Karnataka, where my hometown Karwar is. Now today I'm making a snack that is enjoyed on the coastal side of Karnataka. So this is called Mangalore Buns. So Mangalore Buns is a snack that is enjoyed obviously in Mangalore, but also enjoyed throughout Karnataka. I have some amazing memories enjoying this in my hometown Karwar for my breakfast and as a tea time snack. These are also called banana buns, banana puris. So let's get frying.
For the Mangalore buns, you need an overripe banana, 2 tablespoons of yogurt, you need 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 3 to 4 tablespoons of sugar as per taste, 1/2 teaspoon of jeera, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and you need 2 cups, heaped cups of maida and some extra maida for dusting. So let's start by peeling the banana. The banana is supposed to be overripe for this recipe. So make sure that you mash this banana along with the sugar. It makes it very easy to mash. You can even grind this in a mixer grinder if you please so, but traditionally this is done by hand. So I'm going to mash the banana with the sugar to a smooth puree. Make sure you mash this really well. The sugar is just going to help you liquidize the banana. Now once you have mashed this completely well, you can add the yogurt to this. Now this yogurt, I have kept it outside the refrigerator to make it completely room temperature, and make sure the yogurt is a bit sour, just helps in easy fermentation of the dough. So mix this really well. To this now I'm adding about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. You can add more if you like it, and 1/2 teaspoon of jeera. Now jeera here is completely optional. And to this I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Mix this really well. Now I'm adding here a cup of maida first and mixing this really well. Once you combine the cup of maida, I will start slowly adding the second cup after this. Now you can see the dough is still quite pasty here. Now I will add the second cup of maida, but do this slowly, because if you put the second cup all together, it might just become a very stiff dough, which you don't want. Now this recipe is all about permutation and combination, because it depends on what variety of bananas you're using for the recipe. So if you're using one single banana, if it is a larger variety, you might need a little more maida. Also, if you add a little more sugar, the banana is going to even leave a little more water. So you might have to put a little more maida to this, a little more than 2 cups. So I'm almost finishing my second cup now, and my dough seems to be coming together. Make sure you're combining the maida really well, as in how you're adding it to this mixture. So I have used here 2 full cups of maida, heaped cups of maida. Now I'm going to be adding a tablespoon of ghee to get the dough together. The ghee will just help the dough come together and not stick to your hand or the vessel. So now you can see the dough is looking nice and stiff. It's a soft dough, it's supposed to be a soft dough, and this is going to be fermenting overnight. So once the dough comes together, just cover it and keep it in a warm place overnight.
So last night I made the dough of the banana buns as I showed you, and I left it to ferment overnight, and but now this is how it's expanded and it has fermented really well. So now I need to knead this a little bit and make thick puris and deep fry them. Let's get to cooking this. So I'm just adding a bit of maida to this just to make it a little more pliable. Now the amount of maida that goes into this atta is trial and error, because I really can't tell you the measurement of how much maida goes into this. As long as the atta is coming together, you keep on adding maida to the mixture of banana, and remember not to add any water in this. So I'm just adding maida so that it just becomes easier to handle, and I'm just kneading it lightly. You can also make this with atta, and you can even do half maida and half atta, but the original recipe is made of maida. So that's this recipe right now. So now let me start taking a small ball. I'm just going to put this in a little maida. I have already preheated my oil. So I'm just going to lightly coat this, and I'm going to just make a thick puri out of this. Just make sure you're dusting out all the flour before you put it in the oil. So this is how thick the puri is supposed to be. So do not make it very thin. And now I'm just going to slip it in hot oil and just wait for it to puff up. And that's how it puffs up. Just keep pouring a bit of oil gently and turn it around. And at this point, just lower your flame so that it cooks evenly and does not burn. And that's how you get your perfect Mangalore bun. Now let's get to plating this.
Now these Mangalore buns are absolutely ready to eat. It's raining outside and I'm going to show you how you eat them. I've taken here some safed makhan and I have some coconut chutney. Originally it's eaten with chutney or a vegetable kurma, but I'm going to enjoy this with some white butter. So I'll show you how it is from inside. So this is how it should look, completely hollow and ready and thick. So enjoy the mango buns, tell me how you like it, and keep watching my recipes. Thank you.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.